Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to welcome all of y'all to our Tupelo City Council meeting of Tuesday, March 15th of 2016. At this time, will you all rise with me and Councilman Beard, will you lead us in our invocation, please?
Father, we thank you for health and strength. We thank you for the ability that you give the leaders of our city and pray for guidance as we make decisions concerning the will of our city. We pray for those who are sick, the several on our council members that are suffering a loss, so we pray for them. We ask for guidance tonight to do your will. In Christ's name, amen.
Remain standing and I'll lead you in our pledge. Attention, pledge.
Salute.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. I'll now call this meeting to order and I'll ask our Vice President, Mr. Lynn Bryan, for the confirmation or amendment of the agenda and the agenda order.
Mr. President, I make a motion that we confirm the agenda with the addition of a proclamation in recognition of the Boys and Girls Club and the deletion of item 7.3, which is the review and accept the FY 2015 City of Tupelo audit.
Second.
I have a motion by Councilman Bryan, a second by Mr. Whittington. All in favor? That is unanimous. We'll begin this evening with item 4, proclamations, recognitions, and reports agenda. 4.1, I don't believe we have any girl or boy scouts here tonight. So we'll go to 4.2, recognition of city employees. Mayor Shelton.
There are none tonight, President Palm.
Okay, there are none tonight. We'll go to 4.2A, proclamation and recognition of the Boys and Girls Club.
Thank you, President Palmer. If I could, at this time, I think we've got several representatives with the Boys and Girls Club, at least one or two. Ms. Zell, if you'd come forward, and who else is with the...
No one else.
Come on up.
And one from Haven Acres Club just walked in. All right.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm going to turn the mic over after the proclamation to Ms. Zell Long. I think anyone that not only does as much for the community as she does, but that has eight children. Can take the mic and say what they want when they want, and so I'll do that. But at this time, also before doing that, I did have a note. Ms. Zell Long, that's here with us tonight, was named Executive of the Year for the Boys and Girls Club Southeast Conference, and our friend Ted Mole was named Board Member of the Year at the Southeast Conference. Can we recognize Zell? And I know she won't say it, but Tzatziki's is a great place to eat if you ever get hungry. At this time, on behalf of the council, the administration, the city of Tupelo, would like to issue the following proclamation on behalf of the Boys and Girls Club. Whereas the youth of Tupelo, Mississippi are tomorrow's leaders, and many young people ages 6 to 18 need professional youth services to help them reach their full potential. Whereas there are two Boys and Girls Clubs in Tupelo, Mississippi, in the Haven Acres neighborhood and Park Hill community, providing services to more than 600 young people annually. The Boys and Girls Clubs are places where great futures start. They're at the forefront in efforts in academic success, healthy lifestyles, and good character and citizenship. Whereas the Boys and Girls Club organizations in our state help ensure that our young people spend quality time during after-school hours and summer months in a safe and supportive place with caring professionals presenting quality programs, and the Haven Acres and Northside Boys and Girls Clubs of Tupelo, Mississippi will celebrate National Boys and Girls Club Week 2016 along with more than 4,000 clubs and 4 million young people nationwide. Therefore, on behalf of the City of Tupelo, I do hereby proclaim March 6th through 12th as Boys and Girls Club Week in Tupelo, Mississippi, and call on all citizens to join me in recognizing and commending the Boys and Girls Clubs of North Mississippi for providing comprehensive and effective services to the youth of our communities. Proclaimed on the 6th day of March, 2016. Thank you, Zell.
I just want to say thank you so much to the City of Tupelo. Without your support that you give us at the two clubs, Haven Acres and Northside, we couldn't serve the children. We couldn't be operating. And so we appreciate that so much. And I told Don I really want to come back to you and give you an update on the renovations that's going on at the Northside Club. But we've got with us tonight Nolan Elsey, who is the unit director at the Northside Club. And they're averaging approximately 88 members a day at the club, and their honor roll GPA was 3.1 this past 9 weeks. And we have a new director, Stephanie Parrish. Miss Maddie was at the Haven Acres Club, and she's still there, but she asked to step down. So Stephanie is the new director at the Haven Acres Club, and their GPA was 3.2 this past 9 weeks. And Stephanie, you're averaging 55 to 60 children a day. So the clubs are having impact in the community. We are still zero teen pregnancies for the past 5 years. Boys and Girls Clubs work. And thank you so much for all that you do to support us in that area. We appreciate it.
We'll now go to item number 4.3, public recognitions. Mayor, excuse me.
Well, President Palmer, I know Ms. Nettie, or Councilwoman Davis, was going to recognize everyone that participated in the Our Mississippi Honors Gala this past weekend. I didn't make notes of who all the award recipients were and who all the speakers were, but I know Mr. Jack Reed Sr. Received a recognition, and also Governor William Winter received recognition. And I'm sure there was others that she would have mentioned, but it's a great annual banquet that was this past weekend in Tupelo.
Any other public recognitions?
I just wanted to give an update on Ms. Nettie. She was here, planned to be at the council, and she got word that her sister-in-law had passed out, and so she had to leave to go check on her. She is planning on coming back. I also know that she had planned to mention the Cobb and Northington family in the death of Henry Cobb's mother. I think she wanted to mention that, so be in prayer for them.
Thank you, Mr. Beard. We'll all remember Nettie's family at this time. We'd ask that. 4.4, Mayor, the Mayor's report.
Thank you. I do have another proclamation that I would like to take this opportunity to issue, and we have several members here with the American Red Cross. Could you gentlemen please come forward with me? And it's my fault for not timely submitting this to the agenda for the council meeting, but I thought I would use this opportunity to issue this following proclamation. And this is Joe Lucas and Michael Upton and Colonel Salisbury. And I'll mention, you can't tell it from my long hair because I haven't had a haircut, a timely haircut, but Colonel Salisbury was my ROTC commander when I was in the Air Force ROTC, and he's reminded me I need to get a haircut here tonight. But at this time, on behalf of the council, administration, and City of Tupelo, I'd like to issue the following proclamation of declaring American Red Cross Month. Whereas the American Red Cross Month is a special time to recognize and thank our everyday heroes, those who reach out to help people in need, and the American Red Cross heroes help disaster victims recover. They give blood to help a hospital patient. They brighten the day of an injured service member. They step forward to help someone having a heart attack. And whereas we would like to remember our heroes in Tupelo who help provide assistance to people in need. Across the country and around the world, the American Red Cross responds to disasters. When an injured service member ended up in the hospital far from home, the Red Cross offered comfort. When the hospital patient needed blood, the Red Cross blood donors helped him. When a lifeguard jumped in to save a drowning child or someone stepped up to help a heart attack victim, the American Red Cross was there. Whereas we dedicate the month of March to all those who support the American Red Cross mission to prevent and alleviate human suffering in the face of emergencies. Our community depends on the American Red Cross, which relies on donations of time, money, and blood to fulfill its humanitarian mission. Therefore, on behalf of the City of Tupelo, as Mayor of the City of Tupelo, I do hereby proclaim March 2016 as American Red Cross Month in Tupelo, Mississippi, and encourage all citizens to support this organization and its noble humanitarian mission. Proclaim this 15th day of March, 2016. Thank you.
As a volunteer, I just want to remind the board that we're a short number here because the majority of our numbers are out west helping with flood victims. So please remember those volunteers there and those victims that we're assisting as of right now. Thank you.
The only other two things I'd mention, the mayor's report, as everyone on the council is aware, but just a reminder to the folks at home, this weekend is the Tupelo Barbecue Duel. This year, it's starting with a special St. Patrick's Day concert in Fair Park from 7 to 10 p.m. Thursday night. Then the barbecue competition and different music that goes along with that festival will begin Friday and will go through this year Sunday. So it's expanded from a two-day to a four-day event this year. Hopefully the weather will cooperate. It's certainly gorgeous right now, and I hope that will continue through the weekend. Councilwoman Davis is back. I mentioned the Our Mississippi banquet while she was out and didn't know if the council might let her also address that. But I did want to mention, even though some of us here are Republican and some of us here are Democrats, Ms. Nettie Davis was elected by the Lee County Democrat Party to the Executive Committee and as a delegate to the Congressional District Presidential Convention, which will be coming up soon. I want to congratulate her on that accomplishment. With that, that would conclude the report, and congratulations again, okay. Councilwoman Davis.
Okay.
Thank you. Ms. Davis, we're glad to have you back. Would you like to speak?
I'm sorry I'm late, but my sister-in-law fell, and we thought she had passed out, but she's all right. She fell in the yard, so that's why I'm late coming back in. But the Our Mississippi event was very successful, well attended, and we honored two of our very outstanding people in the community, Jack Reed Sr. and William Winters, and one of the representatives, Mr. Ellis. And it was a very well attended event. People from all over the state, and they had representatives from all of the corporate companies in Mississippi there to give support to this. So it was a very, very worthwhile event. Sponsored by Our Mississippi Magazine, which Wesley Wells is the editor of that magazine.
Thank you, Ms. Daddy. We'll now close the regular meeting and open public agenda. Item 5 has no items at this time, so we'll close the public agenda and return to the regular session, beginning with item number 6, action agenda 6.1, review approved development agreement of Tupelo Crossroads LLC.
Make a motion, we'll approve.
Second.
I have a motion by Mr. Markle Whittington, a second by Mr. Willie Jennings. Discussion, Mayor?
Council President, this is the commercial development on the southwest corner of what would be North Gloucester and Barnes Crossing Road. This is the acceptance of the plan for that development, which would include all of the details of the development that much to be done for that. So this is to help that. This would include things like the ingress and egress to the development with potential future red lights, an agreement to alter that in the future if additional red lights are placed in the proximity. But long story short, this would be to spur that development in Tupelo.
Thank you. Any other questions? All those in favor? That is unanimous. Item 6.2, review approved resolution calling for special election major thoroughfare program phase 6.
Make a motion to table.
Second.
I have a motion to table this item. Have a second. We have a motion by Mr. Whittington, second by Mr. Lynn Bryant. There is no discussion. All in favor? That motion has been tabled. We'll go to now item 7, routine agenda, beginning with 7.1, review approved minutes of regular council meeting of Tuesday, March 1st, 2016.
So moved. Second.
I have a motion by Mr. Beard, a second by Mr. Whittington. All in favor? That's unanimous. 7.2, review and pay bills.
I make a motion we pay bills.
Second.
I have a motion by Mr. Jennings to pay bills, a second by Mr. Lynn Bryan. Tonight we had Lynn, Travis, Ms. Nettie, and Willie that paid bills. All in favor to pay bills? That's unanimous. Thank you. Item 7.3 has been removed by Vice President Bryan, so we'll go to 7.4, review award / reject bid selection for Daybright Roof Project.
So moved. Second.
We have a motion to approve this bid by Mr. Lynn Bryan, a second by Mr. Whittington. Mayor Shelton.
Thank you, President Palmer. This is a continuation of the same project there for Daybright, this community development block grant. The lowest bidder was Medford Roofing, and would be to continue that project. It was CDF, the State Mississippi Development Authority, to keep Daybright here as a what they term an in-game facility, meaning a permanent facility in that corporate structure.
Thank you. Any other comments or questions? All in favor? That's unanimous. Thank you. We'll go to item 7.5. Excuse me, I'm sorry, I lost my place, which is review approved disbursement request number 5.
I make a motion that we approve the disbursement request number 5.
Second.
We have a motion by Mr. Beard. We have a second by Mr. Jennings. Mayor Shelton.
Thank you, President Palmer. Again, this is the, I guess, the next scheduled payment in the ESCO lighting project, the energy efficiency and savings project through Schneider Electric. And again, we'll just remind folks at home and anybody watching that while this is a large figure, this is part of the renovation project of the 27 different parks and ball fields and buildings of the city of Tupelo that will result in a tremendous savings over the life of the project for the city of Tupelo, as well as a better product that would aid in recruitment of sports-related tourism events in the city of Tupelo.
Thank you, Mayor. Any other questions or comments? All in favor? We'll now go to 7.6, review, award, or reject bid selection for Theron-Nichols Splash Pad Project.
Mr. President, I would like to make a motion to move to award the bid on Theron-Nichols Park Splash Pad Construction Project, including the base bid plus adding alternate 1 through 11 and 13 to the lowest and best bid by CIG contractors, and authorize the mayor to enter into contract with CIG and issue a notice of proceeding contingency upon legal review of the contract by the city attorney and subsequent ratification by the city council.
Second.
We have a motion to award the bid by Mr. Willie Jennings. We have a second by Mr. Lynn Bryan. Mayor Shelton.
Thank you, President Palmer. Councilman Jennings' motion was very well stated. This would And of course, we've got the architect, Park and Rec, and grant departments all here. But this would allow us to move forward with that project, would include the add-ons for the project. We will get in the next agenda item to the community safe room, but the infrastructure will be interconnected or interrelated. But the additional part of Councilman Jennings' motion of allowing us to enter the contract will save about a month's worth of time on the project and would authorize myself to enter that contract for the project, which would then come back simply to be ratified at the next council meeting.
Thank you, Mayor. Any comments?
I would just like to say I played with my colleague yesterday by doing this. It's going to be tremendous. It's something that Southern Heights and the community around have been working on so long that would draw families out to park. And that's what I'm about, is trying to help, and the council is trying to do, is help bring families to the park. And this splash pad is an item that will, I feel like, will help bring families to the park and enjoy it, the park more, in Thorne-Nixon Park. So I appreciate your support on that.
Thank you, Mr. Jennings. Any other comments? All in favor? That is unanimous. Thank you. Item 7.7, review, ratify construction contract for Thorne-Nixon Safe Room.
Make a motion to ratify the construction.
Second.
We have a motion by Mr. Markle Whittington, a second by Mr. Travis Beard. Mayor?
Thank you, President Palmer. This is the safe room, community safe room that will be installed there at Thorne-Nixon. I just would like to remind particularly folks watching at home that this is part of a FEMA and MEMA grant. This is over $1 million project, but the city's match is only 10% of the total project cost. The previously mentioned splash pad, we also received a $150,000 grant for infrastructure improvements there. So the two projects combined, you're getting over a $1.5 million addition to the park there in the southern end of the city of Tupelo, but the city is only bearing a percentage or a fraction of that total cost. So I think that it would be a great project to move forward with. And again, CIG Contractor is the same contractor that was awarded the bid for the splash pad. Was the lowest and best bidder for this project, which should improve the efficiency of both projects moving forward there at the same time in Thorne-Nixon.
Thank you, Mayor. Any other comments? All in favor? That's unanimous. Thank you. 7.8, review, ratify construction contract for Lee Acres Safe Room.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion by Mr. Travis Beard, a second by Ms. Nettie Davis. You want to repeat that, Mayor?
I would repeat word for word, with the exception of Century Construction was the low bidder on this one, and it will not have an adjoining splash pad, but it will provide the safety and community benefits for our citizens.
Thank you, sir. Any other comments? All in favor? That's unanimous. Item 7.9. Review, ratify contract for West Jackson Street Development Area 1 project. Also has a note stating that backup material on file in the council clerk's office.
So moved.
We have a motion by Mr. Lynn Bryan. We have a second by Ms. Nettie Davis. Mayor Shelton.
Thank you, President Palmer. This is the continuation of the West Jackson revitalization project. This is essentially the infrastructure, utilities, different, infrastructure improvements to allow the developers to come in and build homes there for our citizens and potential citizens.
Thank you. Any other questions? All in favor? That's unanimous. Thank you, sir. 7.10, review, accept minutes of special call planning committee meeting of February 22nd, 2016.
Make a motion to accept the minutes.
Second.
We have a motion by Mr. Whittington and a second by Mr. Willie Jennings. Do we have a need for a discussion? Are you, Mayor?
Typically not, President Palmer. If you could indulge me one moment on this one, just would like to mention that this does include a new residential development in the city of Tupelo. I think we've determined that to be 26 houses, new homes in the city of Tupelo, which is just phenomenal news for our city.
Absolutely. Any other comments? All in favor? That's unanimous. 7.11, review approved change order number 4 for wastewater treatment plant nutrient removal.
I move that we would approve change order number 4.
Second.
I have a motion by Ms. Nettie Davis, a second by Councilman Beard. Mayor Shelton or Mr. Timmons?
If I could defer to Mr. Timmons from 7.11 through 7.13.
Okay.
He gets into big words that I can't quite.
We got him up here.
Handle.
This change order is for the wastewater treatment plant. As you know, we had a contract for $2,990,000 to complete this project, which we have. This is the final change order. This is for the alum injection into the wastewater for removal of the phosphorus in the wastewater plant. And I just need your approval for $4,533 for this change order.
Any comments, Council? All in favor? That would be unanimous. 7.12, review, ratify contracts for following project. We'll begin with item A, Tupelo SRF, FY14 Water System Improvements, Area 5, West Area.
Make a motion to ratify.
Second.
I have a motion by Mr. Whittington to ratify, a second by Mr. Bryan. Mr. Timmons.
This is, again, for in the newly annexed area for the water in the western part of the city. Last previous meeting, y'all approved the bid and the contract on this for $1,615,000. This is just the approval of the contract piece, the final piece of it. And Ben, I think, has reviewed those contracts today. So.
Any comments, questions? All in favor? That's unanimous. The next part of that motion would be to review ratify contract number B, Tupelo SRF 14 Water System Improvements, Purnell Road Elevated Water Storage Tank.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Mr. Jennings, a second by Mr. Whittington. Mr. Timmons.
This is a water, actually a half-a-million-gallon water tank to be installed on Purnell Road for the newly western annex area, also for fire protection and water capacity for the western side of the city. This contract is for $1,192,000, and again, it's just the approval of the contract piece for this.
Thank you. Any other comments? All in favor? That's unanimous. 7.13, review, award, or reject bids for Tupelo Water and Light Department.
I move that we would award bids for Tupelo Water and Light Department.
Second.
We have a motion by Ms. Nettie Davis, a second by Mr. Beard. Mr. Timmons.
The first bid is bid number 1403, Water and Light, for wooden poles. This is for a 12-month supply of wooden poles. And recommend the low bid with Thomason Lumber Company.
Any comments? The motion was to award these bids for Tupelo Water and Light. All in favor? That is unanimous. Thank you, Mr. Timmons. I think.
No, that,
you got to
do it. Oh, okay.
Yeah,
okay. Stay right here. You need a chair?
No, you do.
Just checking. Item 7.14, review, award.
No.
He's still got each one.
I missed 13. Okay.
1404, 1405, and 1407.
Yeah. Time out just a moment, please. I've got it now. We've already got that one.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll go to the bid number 144WL fiber project to the low qualified bill bids as indicated on attached bid tabulation.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion by Mr. Lynn Bryan, a second by Mr. Travis Beard. Mr. Johnny Timmons.
This is bid number 1404, Water and Light. This is for our fiber cable materials. As you know, we have a fiber loop around the city, and we do a 12-month supply bid to maintain that fiber loop around the city. Basically, it is predominantly the low bid was Utilicor, but there are a couple others in there that were low bid, and we approved those, so.
Thank you, Mr. Timmons. Any questions? All in favor? That passes unanimously. Thank you. We'll now go to bid number 145WL, concrete poles.
So moved.
Second. We have a motion by Mr. Jennings, a second by Mr. Markle Whittington. Mr. Timmons.
Bid number 1405, water and light, is for concrete poles. It's for a 12-month supply, and low bidder was Stress Creek, which have been low bidder for prior years, and it's a very good product, so I recommend that too.
Any comments, Council?
Mr. Timmons, I was just curious, that concrete pole and wooden pole, can you explain to the public what's the difference, why you use those different poles like that?
The wood pole, of course, is, you know, they have like a 30 to 40 year life. Concrete poles are, you're guaranteed anywhere from 70, 80 years of life. You don't have the deflection in them. A lot of times you see them out over a period of years, they'll bow and get the camber in them, what we call camber. But anyway, the concrete pole stays steady and never loses its camber.
So you're potentially geared towards using the concrete pole?
Yeah, that, and then we've also moved into steel poles.
Okay.
We have a lot of transmission lines that are used a lot heavier poles, so we've converted those to steel. We're slowly but surely getting away from wood poles.
Oh, okay. Thank you. Yeah.
Any other questions? Motion to approve this bid. All in favor? That's unanimous. We'll now go to bid number 147, water and light, water materials.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion by Mr. Lynn Bryan, a second by Mr. Whittington. Mr. Timmons.
Again, this is bid number 1407, water and light is water, 12 months water supply materials for water department. Would make the point of items 18 and 20, which were central pipe, was a low bid on those, but they bid a Hymax emergency clamp, and we specify a Mueller clamp, just due to the fact that it actually takes three men to put one of these Hymax connectors on, and so we don't need that. They also, the items 152 through 165, then 167 through 175, we spec a Mueller connector on that, and the Ford item just does not meet spec. We've had failures with those, so we broke those out years ago. They just, the brass does not hold up. So I'd recommend those too also.
All in favor, Council? That will be unanimous. Thank you, Mr.
Thank
Timmons.
You.
Item 7.14, review, award, or reject bid 1413 PW for, that would be Public Works, for curb and gutter for Public Works Department.
Make a motion we award the bid.
Second.
I have a motion to award the bid by Mr. Markle Whittington, a second by Mr. Travis Beard.
Thank you.
Mr. Shelton.
Thank you, President Palmer. And Director Williams is here if additional information is needed. But this is the annual bid for the curb and gutter work for the city of Tupelo. There was only one bidder, Slayton Concrete, and that's for that work for the city of Tupelo.
Any further questions or statements? All in favor? That's unanimous. Thank you. 7.15, review, award, or reject bid 114-1411 PW for riprap, surge, and gabion stone for Public Works Department.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Mr. Travis Beard, a second by Ms. Nettie Davis. Mayor?
Thank you, President Palmer. As you mentioned, that's for the riprap, surge, and gabion stone that is needed. The details there, prices of each one of them are in your packet, but that is for the annual purchase of those materials. And Boonville Trucking, I believe. Boonville. The Public Works has recommended Boonville Trucking be approved as the low bidder to supply those materials.
Any questions? I have one. What is gabion stone, Mayor?
Well, it's really nice.
Real nice. Okay. Thank you. All in favor? Council? That's unanimous. Thank you, Mayor. Thank you. 7.16, review, award, reject bid 1412 PW for crusher run on Public Works Department, for Public Works Department.
So moved.
We have a motion by Mr. Whittington or Mr. Lynn Brown, a second by Ms. Nettie Davis. Mayor Shelton.
Very similar to the previous announcement, that's the annual purchase by Public Works for the crusher run. The recommendation is also for Boonville Trucking for that contract.
All in favor, council? That's unanimous. Thank you. 7.17, review, award, reject bids, and review and approve owner and contractor's contract for McCullough Boulevard Interchange Reforestation Project.
Make a motion we award the contract.
Second.
We have a motion by Mr. Markle Whittington to award the contract. We have a second by Mr. Lynn Bryan. Mayor Shelton.
Thank you, President Palmer. This is part of the continued revitalization project from the tornado of 2014. This is the low bid for this interchange. The low bid was Michael Hatcher and Associates with a base bid of $74,590. This would include the design and continued planting, reforestation to go along with the revitalization from the tornado to improve that interchange there on McCullough.
Thank you. Any comments? All in favor? That is unanimous. We'll now go to item 8, study agenda, beginning with 8.1, review, discuss franchise agreement with Comcast of Tupelo Incorporated.
Move it up. Move it up.
That item has been moved up. We'll now entertain a motion to determine a need for executive session.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion by Mr. Jennings, a second by Mr. Markle Whittington. I'll turn it over to Mr. Ben Logan.
President Palmer, if y'all will indulge me just 1 second before announcing that need for executive session, just in looking over this agenda tonight, the council and the administration should be commended for investing $8 million in public infrastructure for quality of life projects, reforestation, a splash pad, water and sewer improvements for our annexed areas, redevelopment of Jackson Street neighborhood, two new commercial or a commercial subdivision up the mall and the residential subdivision East Tupelo. It takes everybody working together to do that. It takes some great department heads. It takes even some good engineers and architects out there and a pretty good grant writer because it's costing the city $3.5 million for that $8 million in improvements. So I'm happy to work with y'all, and y'all should be proud of what you're doing. The reason we need to go into executive session is the purchase of real property.
Thank you. All in favor of the need? I'll now entertain a motion to go into executive session.
I move that we go into executive session.
So moved.
I have a
motion. Let me second.
I have a motion by Ms. Nettie Davis. I have a so moved by Mr. Lynn Bryan. All in favor? We'll now go on executive session. We appreciate y'all being here.